What is happening, Crocodile? My name is Dre, and welcome back to another video. If you haven't followed me on Instagram yet, you can follow me right here at JustPlainDre, or there will be a link in the description box below. And also, if you're not a subscriber yet, come on, man, come on. Why haven't you subscribed yet? Hit that subscribe button down below, and then click that notification bell so you can be notified every time I upload a new video. And on today's video, I'm going to be doing a review on the Crewz pleated trousers. Now, before we take a look at the trousers themselves, I do want to talk about why I picked up these specific trousers. Now, if you're into high fashion, you may have heard of a very specific pair of pants from a brand called Un Plissé by Isemeyaki. And if you haven't heard of them, well, this is what they look like. And really, in the fashion community, these are definitely one of the more sought-after pieces, because not only are they comfortable, but they look really, really good. But of course, it being a high-fashion brand means that it's kind of expensive. If you look online right now, you could probably find it for $250 to $300 or more. And generally, that's just not an amount I'm willing to spend on some clothes. Granted, that's not to say that the quality is not worth it, it definitely is. But you know your boy, always looking for that affordable alternative, or generally the look for much less. And that's where the Crewz pleated trousers come in. Now off the bat, there are definitely some differences between these and the Isemeyaki trousers, but we'll get into that later on. So without further ado, let's take a look at the trousers themselves. Now I did pick this up in two different colors, their black ones and their dusk ivory ones. This first one that I'm showing you, of course, is the black pair. Let me tell you right now, come on, these pants look amazing. And honestly, I love the fit of these pants. As you can see, it definitely is a straight cut pant, and it is a little bit on the wider side, but not too wide. Definitely not as wide as some of the other Isemeyaki pants, but I think this is just the perfect kind of width for me. Now, when it comes to the waistband, it is an elasticated waistband. It is garterized, so sizing and fit should be a little bit more comfortable and a little bit easier. And again, if you are curious or you're not sure about your size, they do have a size guide on their website. Or if you're still unsure after looking at that, just shoot them a DM on their Instagram and they'll definitely reply and help you out. Their customer service is actually really, really good, at least in my experience. Material wise, I love how flowy this thing is. Now, I do want to mention though that the black pair is actually made of a different material as opposed to the dusk ivory ones. And upon asking Crewz, it was mainly because of the fact that they couldn't source the same kind of material in that color. So for the black pair, the material is this thicker kind of material as opposed to the dusk ivory, which you'll see later on. And it does kind of remind me a little bit more of some kind of corduroy, although a much thinner and flowy kind of corduroy. It does kind of have this velvety vibe to it, which I do like. Definitely adds to the very high quality vibe of this piece. And of course, it being a thicker material, the pants are a little bit weightier than the other one. It does have a little bit more weight to it. But material wise, I do like this material. I think it looks really, really nice and feels nice as well. Now for pockets, although it does have two side pockets, it doesn't have any kind of back pocket, which is kind of unfortunate because I would at the very least want one back pocket, generally just from a utility perspective, because I don't really want to ruin the silhouette and the look of the pants by putting something in my side pockets. But nevertheless, it's not really that big a problem. Side pockets are roomy enough for you to be able to fit your essentials like your wallet or your phone without really showing too much bulk on the pants itself. Now, with all that being said, really my one main gripe about this pair of pants, and this is something you can see on this pair and on the dusk ivory pair, and upon taking a look at some photos of other people who've bought these pair of pants, I did notice that it is something that's present not only on my pair, and it's that the cuffs here on the bottom do develop this kind of a wavy little effect on them. I don't really know what causes this. So if that's something you're not into or you don't like the look of that, that might be a little bit of an issue for you. Personally, it doesn't bother me that much at all. Granted, I would prefer if it didn't do that, but honestly, it's not enough of a reason to prevent me from buying these pair of pants or for liking them for that matter, because I really do like these. Now, again, like I said, I love the cut and the fit of these pants, just the right width and just the right kind of straight cut for me. Now for sizing, I am a size 32 waist, and I did go through the size based on their guide. On their website, I did go for the large, and I did find that these fit me perfectly true to size. And speaking of fit, they do fit a little bit more high-waisted, which I honestly really, really like. But overall, I love this black pair, and it definitely is one of, if not my new favorite pair of black trousers. They're super comfortable to wear, and even if it is a thicker material, it's not really hot at all, in my opinion. And honestly, when wearing an outfit, switching out a regular pair of black trousers for these black trousers definitely elevates your outfit that much more, and definitely gives you more of that high fashion, high-end look. Now moving on to the dusk ivory pair, I also love these trousers. These pants look amazing, come on! Now when it comes to choosing the color, they did have a cool gray, and based off of the photos on the site, I did have a little bit of trouble deciding or figuring out which was the color that I wanted. It was the dusk ivory, but I wasn't sure which was which because the photos on their site are a little too similar. So I did have to go and message them on their Instagram and ask them for a side-by-side kind of comparison of the two pants so I could figure out which version was the color that I wanted. Now speaking of the color of these pants, it has kind of this ivory color, but if you mix in a little bit of some kind of light seafoam green, you get this color. So it's like this gray slash ivory with a little bit, like a very, very slight tinge of green. Definitely a color for a pair of pants I don't yet own in my wardrobe, so I think this is great. And again, it's still being close to that kind of gray slash off-white family when it comes to the color. It's still very, very easy to pair with stuff. It's very light and pleasant to the eyes. And honestly, the color just looks really high fashion and really high end to me, like a high quality piece. Now, when it comes to the cut is basically the same thing, the same kind of silhouette with the width and the length, which I think is fantastic. You don't have to worry too much about the different colors fitting differently. So I will say that whatever your size is in one of the colors, it's the same size in the other color. They all pretty much fit the same, which I think is great. Now, when it comes to the material, as you can see, I did say this is a lighter fabric as opposed to the almost corduroy kind of material that the black pair had. And honestly, I don't mind this at all. And in fact, I kind of do prefer this material for this pair of pants, mainly because color-wise, this does kind of evoke a very fresh, very fresco look, very kind of light and pleasant to the eyes. And I think that this material definitely does complement that vibe. With it being a lighter material, definitely does help the pants flow a little more, I will say. The dusk ivory pair is a little bit more flowy than the black pair, obviously, because it is a lighter material. And of course, if you know me, I love the flowy look. And again, although it is a different material, the fit is basically the same thing. I did get both pairs in a large, same height when it comes to the high waist, same width and same length as well. Now again, like I said, both pairs do have the kind of wavy thing going on down here at the bottom cuff, which is a little bit more noticeable on this pair because it is a lighter material as opposed to the heavier material on the black pair. So do take note of that. And again, I will leave it up to you to decide if this is something that's too much for you or something that you don't really care about when it comes to these pants. So of course, if you haven't looked them up yet, you are wondering, Dre, how much are these pair of pants? And I will say they're not necessarily cheap, but they're not necessarily way too expensive either, and they're definitely a far cry from the price of the Isimayaki pants. The pleated trousers from Cruz go for about 1,990 pesos, so basically around 2,000 pesos. This is Philippine pesos, by the way, which comes out to about $40, which in my personal opinion for the quality that you're getting is a total steal. And trust me when I say that I've been looking for an affordable alternative to the Isimayaki trousers for the longest time. I've checked Zara, both men's and women's section, Uniqlo, H&M, and a bunch of other brands, and this is really the closest I've gotten to them in terms of look. The closest I've ever gotten and the closest thing I've found are the pair of pleated trousers that I did show in my previous video that I got from the Uniqlo women's section. Check out that video over here, the waist to style bowling shirts. Highly recommend that video, really good. And yeah, those pleated trousers are the closest I've gotten to a nice pair of pleated trousers. And even then, the pleats are kind of different. They're not as three-dimensional, they're not as thick. And honestly, they just don't look as good as these. And honestly, in my personal opinion, for the quality that you're getting, I think these are totally worth it. The silhouette and the cut of the trousers, I think, are perfect. How straight cut they are and the width of them, I think, is fantastic. And overall, do I recommend them? If it wasn't obvious by now, heck yeah. Are they exactly like the Omplissé Isimayaki pants? No, the Isimayaki pants have a different kind of cut, depending on which variation or which size you get. Honestly, when you look at these pair of trousers as their own piece, I think these are a fantastic pair of trousers. Not only are they a really good affordable alternative to the Omplissé Isimayaki pleated trousers, as a pair of pants on their own, they're just really, really good. And honestly, now owning two good pairs of pleated trousers, I can definitely say that you need a pair of pleated trousers in your wardrobe. And these ones from Cruz are a great choice. For all you girls out there, although Cruz is a brand that mainly caters to menswear, I think their pleated trousers look amazing on women. Here's a couple of women that you may know that have styled these on social media right here, Kim Cruz, and then right here, you got Nadine. So be you a dude or a girl, I highly recommend these trousers. And with that being said, that about does it for my review on the Cruz pleated trousers. Let me know what you think about these trousers. Do you like them? Do you hate them? Are there things you would have changed? Are there things you wish they did better? Let me know in the comment sections below. If you got any questions, comments, or inquiries, then also do let me know in the comment sections below. Now, if you like this video, then definitely smack that like button. It definitely does help me out a lot, and I'm not just saying that. It really does help me out a lot with the YouTube algorithm. So do just take a couple of seconds, scroll down, and just click that like button. If you haven't subscribed yet, then definitely hit that subscribe button and also hit that little notification bell so you can be part of the crocodile squad. What do you call a group of crocodiles? Is there a term for that? Let me know in the comment section below if you know that. If you know anybody else who would like this video or is looking into getting the Cruz pleated trousers, then definitely do share this video to them. Or if you know anybody else who would just generally like my content, your brother, your sister, your girlfriend, your boyfriend, your lolo, your lola, your tito, your tita, then again, share my stuff with them. Thanks so much for watching, guys. Stay creative, keep making it. Until next time, see you later, crocodile.